Good morning. This show is for the folks that my viewers that I call the political polytubers, my viewers on YouTube, my fans. You guys have shown that you are very interested in my take on what's going on in the Me Too movement. And luckily, or well, sadly, for the people of Parkland, Florida, Me Too kind of went away for a while because we were covering this mass shooting that took a lot of innocent lives and shouldn't have, by the way. But there were some developments in the Me Too movement while I was covering the breaking news of the Florida school shooting. So here we go. Monica Lewinsky is back in the news. Yeah, you know, the girl who sucked the president's dick, President Clinton, and got famous for it, got a book deal, got her own little line of purses. Yeah, now she says she's Me Too. She's suffering from PTSD because she sucked the president's dick. Yeah, see, I'm going to be talking a little rude today, but that's how I roll because I am trying to be fair here. And I am a woman. And I have sucked dicks. I have given blowjobs to men. I didn't really want to do it, but it was my boyfriend. They liked it, so I did it. Here's what I never did. I never kept any souvenirs from the experience. I didn't think it was appropriate to, you know, I would come home from a long night of sucking my boyfriend's dick and take a shower and throw my clothes in the wash and boom. What did Monica Lewinsky do? She kept a trophy. She kept the dress with the president's sample, shall we call it, on it. Who does that? What victim does that? Look, President Clinton was a terrible husband. He was a great president. We're going to get into a little bit of this later on about being good for your job, but not necessarily being great in your personal life. And whatever you think about President Clinton, he is a man. He was a middle-aged dude, and this young, cute little thing walked into his office and said, "Can I suck your dick?" What warm-blooded heterosexual man is going to say no to that? Come on, let's get fair about this. Even Monica Lewinsky admits even today that their relationship, she wasn't forced to do anything. He never threatened her. She wanted to be the president's girlfriend. She even says in her book, again, she had time to think about it, but when she wrote the book, she said she was in love with Bill Clinton. And she was young and she was stupid. Yes, that is an affliction. We have all been young and stupid, us girls out here. We read too many Daniel Steele books. We read too many Harlequin romances. I think if you really want to delve into Monica Lewinsky, which I have no intention of doing here, she probably in her wildest dreams thought of, oh my God, he's going to leave Hillary and marry me. Because that's what little girls grow up to think when they read these books, these romance books. She offered Bill Clinton something his wife wouldn't do. A lot of men pay professionals to do things their wives won't do. It doesn't mean they don't love their wives. It just means they need a little other action. So yeah, Monica Lewinsky now claiming Me Too is kind of interesting, like I said. And again, Bill Clinton was a terrible husband, but he, in my opinion, my First Amendment protected opinion, he was a good president. I voted for him. I liked him as a president. I wouldn't want to marry him, wouldn't want to date him, definitely wouldn't want to suck his dick. But, again, it was her choice. Now we can go to the Olympics. We didn't talk much about the Olympics on this show, again, because of the breaking news. Shaun White. Now someone's calling Me Too on Shaun White, only after he got a gold medal in the Olympics. Because, see, the woman who is accusing Shaun White of sexual harassment settled a payment dispute with him in 2017, okay? This is 2018. Now, Shaun White has been in the news. He has been in the news all over the place before he won the gold medal. And this woman was nowhere to be found. Nothing was said till he got the gold medal and stood on that podium. Now, he thought he had taken care of this problem. It was a payment dispute. She was a drummer in a band that Shaun White was part of. She says he did not pay her as a drummer. He said, yep, sorry, didn't pay you. Here's your money. Bye. The second he gets a gold medal and he stands on that medals podium, now he is a Me Too. He's accused of sexual harassment, which this woman never did. She wanted her money for the job she did, and she deserved her money for the job she did, believe me. People want to get paid when they do a good job. But only again when he became a gold medalist again and he was on every TV channel holding the American flag did this woman say, oh, by the way, he sexually harassed me too. Come on. Come on. Again, there are real victims out there. There are real victims out there who have been sexually assaulted, domestically abused by a plumber, by an accountant, by a lawyer, by an electrician, by someone who works for the garbage company, or the, you know, someone who is not famous. You don't hear their stories. Because it just seems to me that all of a sudden, women are waiting until the person gets famous, becomes an Oscar nominee, or an award winner, or a gold medalist, and then all of a sudden, Me Too. He's a sexual abuser. He harassed me. I want to know where, because I know they exist, I want to know where the restaurant owner, where the plumber, where the electrician, where the secretaries are, whose bosses are sexually harassing them. I want to know why they're not coming out. Could it be there's no money involved? Could it be that there's no zeros on the end of the one on the check? Why are these women waiting until the men they're accusing become successful? Why? It's a question we need to ask so that women out there, put your thumbs away. I get it. But I'm trying to protect you, the real victims, the people who are afraid to come home from work at night because your husband might have had a few too many beers and might want to take his frustrations out on your face. I want to protect you because when you report that son of a bitch, I want him to be prosecuted and I want you to be believed. But when we have all this other crap coming out, what are we supposed to think now? Your rights could very well be taken away from you by these gold-digging women who only choose to accuse powerful and wealthy men in order to get a paycheck. Ryan Seacrest, okay? Don't like him. I got no dog in Ryan. I will not defend Ryan Seacrest for anything. I don't like him. I'm not a fan, okay? I stopped watching Kelly after Michael Strahan left. So I'm not into Ryan Seacrest, but he is now being accused of sexual harassment in a case that he thought was already, again, taken care of. But now all of a sudden, his hairstylist is coming out saying he sexually harassed me. He was inappropriate to me. And again, like I said, no dogfight with Ryan Seacrest, but why? Why now? Why now? And again, it has been said by Ryan Seacrest and his people that this woman offered to keep her mouth shut if Ryan Seacrest paid her $15 million. That's a lot of money. So again, we have a blackmail accusation. Blackmail, by the way, is also against the law. You can't tell somebody, if you don't pay me, I'm going to spread nasty rumors about you. And let's talk about ex-wives. How many of you, I'm going to give you another homework assignment. And let me tell you, again, must watch the show first in its entirety, and then you can do your assignment. How many of you would list your ex-wife or ex-husband as a job reference? One thing Trump said after two of his people working in the White House had to resign because their ex-wives came out and said, "Me too. He's terrible. He's an abusive person. He pulled me out of the shower and was yelling at me, and when I said let go, he let go." How many of you would put your ex-wife as a job reference? I mean, come on. Look, I've had a lot of bad breakups in my life, right? So I certainly wouldn't expect an employer to call me and ask me about one of my exes' qualifications to do a job. Now, I could be a real bitch about it, but I won't. All I would say to a potential employer is, look, I never worked with the guy. I just sucked his dick once in a while. I really am not the person you want to talk to about his job requirements. He was a bad boyfriend, but he's probably really good at his job. Just like President Clinton was really good at his job, he was just really bad at being a husband. But that's okay. See, that's okay. Because you've got to consider the source. And most ex-wives and ex-husbands are not in a good place with their ex-spouses. So if they get the chance to screw them, they will. They will. And they'll lie to do it. And I agree with President Trump, who, by the way, has cheated on all of his three wives. He's a terrible husband, if you believe all the reports, but we know he at least cheated on Ivana with Marla, and then he cheated on Marla with somebody else, and then he married Melania, and now there's accusations that he cheated on Melania. You know what? That is really not our business. It became our business because Donald Trump brought it up during the election, during the campaign. He said that Hillary Clinton, who basically was the victim of having a bad husband, shouldn't be president because her husband is a dog. Is a bad husband. He cheats on her. I didn't think that having a cheating husband makes you ineligible to have your own job, since you were the victim. And I don't think it's a bad thing that Hillary stuck by Bill. Because she knew what she was getting, kind of, when she married him. Look, men all over the world will pay women to do things their wives won't do. It doesn't mean they don't love their wives. It just means that they need something a little extra. Sometimes they get caught, and sometimes the wives aren't happy about it. And boy, those wives will choose any chance they can get to get even. This is why I don't believe that the two White House staffers should have lost their jobs because of something their ex-wives said happened years ago. I don't think that's appropriate. And as Donald Trump rightly said, there is no proof. They never had their day in court, and yet they resigned their positions. And again, why would an ex-wife's opinion of you as a husband have anything to do with how you can do your job? I don't think that's appropriate. I don't think ex-spouses should be talked to when someone is going out for a job. Because you can just imagine what someone would do if they get the chance. Oh, he wants a big, powerful job now? Yeah. He cut me on my alimony. Oh, yeah. Yeah, give the ex-husband a call. Hey, baby, remember me? They're asking me if you're qualified for your job. How about you up my alimony? And I'll tell them you're awesome. Again, these women, they just keep going after the big dollars, the big powerful men. They try to screw their exes. It's not right. It's not right because of the real victims. The real victims out there. You know, I go to the dentist's office because he's a good dentist. I don't ask if he cheats on his wife, because I don't care. I just care that my teeth look good and they feel good. I don't care if he cheats on his wife. I don't care. I don't care if the guy who comes to fix my plumbing cheats on his wife. I don't care. I don't even care if he tells snarky jokes in the office and offends people. I don't care. As long as my pipes get fixed, that's what I'm paying him for. It is not our business to be the sex police. It is not our business that all our elected officials or our sports stars have to be perfect in their private lives. That's their private lives. That's none of our business. If they can throw a ball and they haven't actually beaten anybody to a pulp or raped anybody or killed anybody, then what do I care? They may cheat on their wives. They may cheat on their girlfriends. It's none of my business. As long as I get a Super Bowl championship t-shirt for my Eagles, their private lives are none of my business. My doctor's private life is none of my business. Unless somehow his private life affects the care that I get from him or her. The private life of my electrician or my plumber or my accountant or my lawyer is none of my business. Unless it affects the way they do their job and do the service I pay them to do. An Olympian who wins a gold medal, I don't give a shit if some drummer didn't get paid. That's none of my business. I wanted to see the dude go down the half pipe on a snowboard and land jumps. That's all I care about. This other crap is his personal business, and it should stay his personal business. And I promise you that if Sean White or Bill Clinton were a plumber or a trash collector or a postman or a lawyer or an accountant, we would never hear their names in response to Me Too. Never. Because we're not hearing anybody connected to Me Too that isn't famous, that doesn't have a lot to lose. That's a problem for me, and it should be a problem for you, and it especially should be a problem for you if you are one of the millions of women who live in fear, who are afraid to come home from work because your husband had a couple too many beers or he had a bad day at work and he's going to take it out on your face. You should be worried. With all these rich people getting sued and getting accused, you should be worried that when you make a complaint, when you've had enough, when you are in the emergency room getting stitches because your husband cut you or hurt you or your boyfriend threw you down a flight of stairs, your nobody boyfriend who isn't rich, who isn't famous, who hasn't been nominated for an award, who hasn't won a gold medal, when they do something to you and nobody believes you because of this crap going on in the entertainment industry right now, you need to worry, because we want to hear your stories. I want to hear your stories of real abuse, of real danger, of real life-threatening situations. Not of all this crap that's coming out with Me Too. Only against rich people, famous people, people we see on TV, people that look good on talk shows. I want to hear your stories. I want to hear about serious, real abuse. Not, oh, somebody told a nasty joke about women in the lunchroom today. I'm a Me Too. I'm offended. There are women and children every day who go to bed and don't know if they're going to wake up tomorrow because they live with a violent person in their home. Someone who could be set off like a bomb, like a ticking time bomb. You never know what's going to set him or her or her. There are female abusers too. Set them off. And you end up getting your face punched in, your nose broken, your cheekbone shattered, your arm broken because it was twisted. These are the real victims of serious abuse. These are the real victims of PTSD after they escape from their abuser, their real abuser. This other shit is just basically that. It's bullshit. And I call BS. And as a woman, it offends me. It offends me that you can get famous for sucking someone's dick and keeping a sample. It offends me that you can accuse somebody after they win something or they get more famous or they make more money of something that happened a decade ago or last century. That offends me. Because I'm worried about the woman who is fighting for her life right now, today. A woman who is sitting in her house terrified that if her husband has a bad day at work, she's going to pay for it. She's going to pay for it with a broken bone or a shattered cheekbone or a black eye or a broken nose. Or things in the house will get broken. Or God forbid he's got a weapon and uses it against her because he had a bad day at work. Or he had too many drinks with the boys after work. Those are the victims that concern political Paula. People who live in fear, children who are afraid of talking up to daddy because daddy might just slam them across the room. These are the real victims. These are the people I care about. And they're everywhere. They are your neighbors, they are your friends, they are your family members, and they live in fear right now, not a century ago, not 10 years ago, and they don't want money. They want to go to bed and feel safe when they close their eyes. And I think they deserve that right to be safe from their consistent abuser. And we need to stop worrying so much about these rich people accusing other rich people of bad behavior, of boys being boys. Yeah, I'll say it. And we need to start getting back to protecting the real victims that are victimized today, that will be victimized this hour, next hour, today, tomorrow, next week, next month, all year. The women that will be murdered by abusive husbands and boyfriends. The children who will be killed by drug-addicted and abusive stepfathers and fathers. And even their mothers as well. Those are the victims we need to be worried about when we talk about abuse and domestic violence and even sexual assault, because many children tonight will go to bed and daddy will walk into their room to have special time with his best girl. That's a real victim. Those are the ones we should be fighting for. Those are the ones that we should be saying, me too, or time's up. These are the abusers that need to be stopped right now, today. Not these rich assholes that can buy their way out of anything. And not the rich women who are accusing them just to get a payday. Can't wait to hear your comments. Political Paula, out.